Blackstone presents His Memory in Ashes, a novel by SM Reine. This book is read by Elise Arsenault and Liam DiCosimo.
Prologue. Hank. I spotted Evangeline Ashe at a hospital 7 years ago and knew instantly I'd marry her. I worked for the Reno Police Department back then. Meeting my future wife on the job was the last thing I expected to happen, especially considering I'd closed out a shift by hauling a junkie into the emergency room. That's how I spent most shifts in those days. Any addict who couldn't be cleared up with naloxone got cuffed to a bed before getting tossed to the jail uptown. When I finally dropped off the trash, Eve had been pacing outside the doors, just far enough from the entrance that she could smoke. Back then, she smoked all the time, walking around in a cloud so I could never quite see through to her face. I only glimpsed her profile as she paced away from the door, lit in red tones by the cherry of her cigarette when she inhaled. She wore lipstick that left a ring of dark red on the filter. "Did you know you can't smoke that here?" I asked. She confessed that she knew, but needed to relax.
"My brother's in the hospital."
Eve's voice was both raspy and velvet. "I'm sorry to hear that," I said. "But you can't smoke here." The breeze picked up. Her hair was blown back, so I finally got a clear look at her gorgeous features, from the sinuous curve of a bottom lip begging to be nipped, to calf eyes rimmed by fatigue. Her eyelashes were long enough to trap tears. Her hair fell in wispy locks, styled to give softness to an angular face. She asked,
"Can I finish this cigarette?"
I'd never wanted to tell someone yes before so badly. I walked away without answering. As long as I didn't have to see it, I didn't have to tell her to stop. After divorcing my first wife, a fat, stuffy bitch named Alice, I spent a few years worth of weekends playing poker at the Atlantis. I was a high roller. They gave me a room, drinks, food, all gratis. All I had to do was keep putting money on the table. I never went home in the red except that weekend I first met my Queen of Hearts. I was so distracted thinking about the specter of Evangeline Ashe, I burned through my chips before church on Sunday morning. It's hard to break a losing streak when you start with a loss as spectacular as the one that had just hit me. When I returned to St. Mary's on Monday, another patrol, another addict, I found Eve walking the halls, haloed by the scent of tobacco. She seemed more waifish in the hospital lighting. I could have lost myself in the shadows of her collarbones. "Still here?" I asked.
"Here again."
Eve stopped outside an open door. Aaron was arguing with a nurse inside, and I'd arrested enough addicts to recognize a man chasing dragons. Eve had been quick to make excuses.
"Childhood trauma," she said. "It's not his fault he has demons."
"You should come to my church. They know what to do with demons there," I said, surprised to hear myself joking. "I mean, they have addiction groups. Come on Sunday. You can ask Pastor Johns about it."
"I don't think Aaron will be out by Sunday. West Hills is taking him this afternoon, and they never hold him less than a week."
Eve was still convinced that Aaron would be okay once he got into the mental hospital, once his meds stabilized, once they got him back off opioids. The nurse left the room looking angry. Aaron remained in his hospital bed like some Jabba-looking asshole sprawled over the sheets, watching TV with a big gulp in hand. Eve gazed at him with love. Big eyes glistening with tears, the smallest smile, fondness in the tilt of her shoulders. Even her bony knees knocked together like she was overcome just looking at him and needed help standing up. "You can come to church without Aaron, too," I said. "I'd love to see you there."
"Okay,"
she said. Eve showed up the next Sunday. She talked to Pastor Johns and let me take her to brunch afterward. Eve ate dainty nibbles of fruit and gave her phone number to me. We went on 3 dates while Aaron was in the hospital. The first time, we hiked Oxbow. The second time was dinner and a movie. The third time started at the Atlantis, passed through my hotel room, and ended with another Sunday at church together.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.